Delta Airlines partnering with Duke University, and Super Bowl tickets are set to be the costliest ever. Jane King is live at the NASDAQ with those stories and more. Good morning, Jane.
Hey, Melissa. Good morning. Yes, Delta and Duke are partnering on a sustainability program. So this involves a combined purchase of 5,000 carbon credits. Now, Biz Journal says Delta, which is the official airline of the university and its athletic program, said the partnership will offset carbon from all Duke business travel on Delta in 2017, while also supporting urban forestry in the Raleigh-Durham area through funding the planting and care of 1,000 new trees. Now, Delta said approximately half of the new trees will benefit historically disadvantaged Raleigh-Durham neighborhoods. Well, Bank of America pulling a free checking account favored by those with low balances. Customers must now have a regular direct deposit of $250 or keep an average balance of $1,500 in the account to avoid the fees. They'll be charged $12 if they don't do those things. And it was a record-breaking day for stocks. Sound familiar? The Dow up 142 points. Congress reached a deal to end the government shutdown. So the S&P 500 and the NASDAQ rose to record highs as well. Well, Netflix joined the $100 billion club. The streaming giant gained far more customers than what was expected over the holidays, and the stock just soared. Now, those customers came even though Netflix raised prices over that same time. Netflix now has 117 million total subscribers. And the cheapest ticket on the resale markets for the Patriots-Eagles Super Bowl is $4,370. That's according to Ticket IQ. Now, Super Bowl 52 prices hold at that level. They would set a new record. Super Bowl 52 will be played at U.S. Bank Stadium in Minneapolis on February 4th, and prices fell $500 after the Minnesota Vikings lost to the Eagles in the NFC Championship game. The Vikings would have become the first team in NFL history to play in a Super Bowl at its home stadium. And Americans do feel confident about the economy and their jobs. A Marist NPR poll found about 84% of Americans say they're not worried about losing their jobs. 9 in 10 Americans believe their employer values their work, and the majority of workers say they got a raise last year. Live from the NASDAQ market site in Times Square, I'm Jane King from Fox 8 News. Back to you.
Thanks so much, Jane. Have a great day. Cyber criminals.